A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 23rd May, on the front page you have Election Commission rejects opposition plea for VPAT tally before vote count. So the opposition parties had demanded that the Election Commission should make sure that whenever there is a mismatch between VPAT and the EVM count in any polling booth, because 5 polling booths per assembly segment would have this VPAT verification done. So if there is any discrepancy, then 100% VPAT verification should be done for that assembly segment. So this was the demand of the opposition parties, and for this they said that is why VPAT tally should be done first and vote counting later. But then Election Commission has rejected this demand of the opposition parties, and it said that today's counting sequence will remain as per Supreme Court approved guidelines, as they have decided that VPAT verification will be done later. So this is there. Then this is documents stolen from Indian Air Force Rafael team office in France. So it is said that the break-in, the documents, original documents with respect to Rafael deal which have come out in the open, so this has been done break-in on the premises of Dassault Aviation in France. So this is detailed here. And this is Center clears names of 4 judges to Supreme Court. So these are the names of 4 judges who had been recommended by the collegium. 2 of them had been, were discussed in news, how they were sent back for reconsideration by the center once, and Supreme Court collegium has reiterated those 2 names and 2 other names. So with the appointment of these 4 judges, the sanction strength of Supreme Court of 31 would be fulfilled. So now there will be 31 judges in the Supreme Court once these appointments are done. Then on page 6 you have scribe activists express concern over fake NRC. So these are news reporters, scribes and activists. So they have expressed concern that in Assam there are a group of people who are raising false objections, and they have their vested interests to harass genuine Indian citizens whose names have appeared in the draft NRC and they have proved their lineage. Still objections are being raised against them. So this point has been raised by activists. So they are harassing genuine citizens. On page 7 you have water experts warn of desertification of Marathwada. So policy makers, it is said, are inducing farmers to adopt incongruent crop patterns which is causing water crisis here. So experts have this viewpoint that this is policy induced failure which is occurring in Marathwada in Maharashtra. On page 8 you have Kochi offers help to solarize airports in international solar alliance countries. So envoys from 37 countries visited the airport in Kerala to understand how solarization of airports takes place, and Kochi has offered to help as such too. Then on page 9 you have ISRO launches radar imaging observation satellite RISAT-2B. So that we had discussed in news how RISAT-2B is an earth observation satellite which will replace RISAT-2. So it can take pictures during day and night, all seeing radars. So also under cloudy situations. So this has been launched now on PSLV C-46 rocket. So it has been placed in 556 kilometer orbit. Then below you have groundwater reserves estimates to be updated soon. So Union Water Ministry is finalizing an updated estimate on state of groundwater reserves in the country. So the last one was such as an assessment was done in 2013, and now again for each state blocks, sample blocks would be picked up and this survey would be undertaken. And this is Armed Forces Tribunal asks Center to submit files on Navy Chief selection. So on the selection of Navy Chief, there has been this petition filed before Armed Forces Tribunal by Vice Admiral Bimal Verma. So he says that he has been superseded for the top post despite being the senior most. So now Armed Forces Tribunal is asking the Center to submit its files regarding the selection for the Navy Chief. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is disclosing dissent. So this says that people are entitled to know whether or not the poll panel's key decisions are unanimous. So this is regarding the minority dissenting view, whether it should be part of the model code of conduct or not. The Election Commission ruled it will not be part of the opinion or the order of Election Commission, But the editorial argues that people are entitled to know whether or not the poll panel's key decisions are unanimous. And below you have Eye in the Sky. So this is regarding RESAC-2B, which has been launched. So it will enhance India's monitoring capabilities for civil as well as military purposes. The lead article, The Search for a Majority. So this talks of how BJP's Hindutva demographic is founded upon splitting and depoliticizing hereditary identities. And below is about, again, looking for secular alternatives. It says if the non-BJP parties don't coordinate, the Muslim community's struggle for fair representation will continue. Then on the OPED page, you have a blueprint for a national security strategy. So it says the new government must build on D.S. Huda's outline. So this is regarding security, a national security strategy that has to be formulated. So several attempts have been made, you know, for such a strategy for India. So now it says that a blueprint for national security strategy should be developed. It should be built on D.S. Huda's outline, which has been put forth. So this should be the task for the new government in power. Then on page 12 you have UP retains 15 for baseless accusations against EVMs. So police has asked officials to take action against rumor mongers. So rumor mongers are being now detained. Then on page 13 you have determined to fight terror, Sushma. So this is Defence Minister Sushma Swaraj. She interacted with Pakistani counterpart Mr. Qureshi for the first time after the Pulwama strike at the Shanghai Cooperation Organization meet in Bishkek in Kyrgyzstan. Then on international page you have EU goes to polls. So this is regarding European Parliament polls. The details are given out here, in which even UK is participating. And this is Duterte orders Canada's garbage to be shipped back amidst diplomatic row. So this is Philippines President Rodrigo Duterte. He has ordered tons of garbage dumped in Philippines years ago to be shipped back to Canada. So Ottawa actually missed May 15 deadline on this issue. So Ottawa did not formally accept the shipment of trash. So now it will be dumped inside Canada's territorial waters, is what Philippines says. And this is in a first, Arabic novel wins International Booker. So this is a writer from Oman, Jorkha Al-Harthi. She has shared the award with her translator, Marilyn Booth. So she's won the International Booker Award. Man Booker International. Then on business page you have, new government must focus on bank balance sheets. So successive regimes have shown capacity to deliver fiscal discipline, but equally a casual attitude to slippages. So this has been highlighted that now new government must focus on bank balance sheets and not allow such slippages. And this is crisis in NBFC, non-banking finance company sector could hurt economic growth. So there are subdued mutual fund flows, there are delays in monetary transmission and high risk aversion. As such, as is being seen, so this may slow down the NBFC sector, is what is predicted. Then there's no important news on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.